All right, so today we're doing fractions here today. We've got three fractions here. We're going to add these up and see what these come to. Does anyone know where we're going to start? We're going to start today on this problem. Yes.
Why do we have to know this? When am I ever going to use this?
This here? Fractions?
Yeah.
Well, fractions are used a lot all over real life, but let me ask you a different question. Do you like money?
Yeah.
If you were to choose in the future of having more money or less money, what would your choice be?
More.
More. Interesting. Do you guys feel the same? You'd rather have more money than less money? Well, it's interesting because math, I mean, while you're going to use fractions a lot in life, with mathematics, I'm going to share you a secret about mathematics that you may not know. There's a lot of research and some evidence out there in stats that say things like this. If you want to make more money, take more math. Well, why? What's that about? Well, if we read some of these things up here, we can see that we see some stats, for example, that according to this National University study, this guy did some statistics and said that starting salaries across all industries tend to increase by about $2,000 for every math class that someone has taken after ninth grade. So that's nice. So you can think about padding your pocketbook a little bit. And look at down here. The top 10 highest starting salaries in 2009 involve a generous amount of mathematics. The more math we take, it could open up some doors to the future. But look at this. Here's another thing here. We could take a look at this. We see that emphasize numbers in your course curriculum and you can expect to see higher numbers in your bank account. That's the consensus of several studies, including some by here. Look at this. According to this, all 15 college majors with the highest earnings potentially rely on math skills. So that they use math. So interesting. So more math we take, it's possible we could earn more money with the jobs we get. And look at this one here. We see some stuff here that a strong grounding in high school mathematics through Algebra 2 or higher correlates powerfully with access to college, graduation from college, and earning in the top quartile of income from employment. So why should we learn math? Well, one reason, man, it seems like if you can work hard and do well at math, it's going to open up some possible doors for you to increase your earning potential, just have different opportunities that may help you out there. So, in fact, with all school in general, we can see this is kind of old graph here, but we can see we got the high graphs being college versus high school. If you work hard now and you kind of work hard to get this math and get into, you know, and if you choose to go into a college, if that's your choice, we can see that over the course of the long run, if you want more money, I suggest working hard now. Get as much now that you can, because it's going to open up more opportunities for you later on. And lots of jobs. All right, there was number two. Okay.